Look, the short answer is no. Nuclear batteries are not as dangerous as they seem. But hold on, then. But I have a feeling that you're going to find the long answer to be way more interesting. So let's see if we can't figure this out together. I'm Ricky, and this is Tuba Da Vinci. This video is brought to you by eufy. This is a Geiger counter. We got it for this episode to kind of just see what we could find around the house. And this turned out to be the worst offender. This is actually a ceramic plate made by a company called Fiestaware. And turns out to get this color glaze, when they made this, they used depleted uranium. And just look at those numbers. Now, I know that radioactivity is incredibly complicated and scary and hard to understand. But before I tell you why, let me get this far away from me. Radioactivity is scary. I get it. Nuclear fallout, Fukushima, Chernobyl, cancer. But mostly because we can't see, smell, or taste radioactivity. It's like a silent killer you only find out about when it's too late. We actually made a video about nanotritium batteries from a company called City Labs, which we'll link to here. But those are for specialty applications like sensors and electronics in remote locations. We're talking about nuclear batteries for the masses here. Or at least that's what Betavolt, the company making this battery, paints it to be. But if we're going to have nuclear-powered batteries and things like smartphones that we have on our person, this really matters. And is it safe? A typical nuclear battery can store 3,000 to 5,000 watt-hours per kilogram, compared to 150 to 300 watt-hours per kilogram for the best lithium-ion batteries. So we can make nuclear batteries dozens of times smaller and lighter than lithium-ion batteries. Take a 16-inch MacBook Pro battery, for example. It stores 99.6 watt-hours and weighs 355 grams. A nuclear battery with the same capacity would only weigh 20 to 30 grams and would be the size of a penny. The second benefit is that nuclear batteries can last a long time. City Labs' nanotritium batteries last 12.5 years, but the BV100 lasts 50. Why? Because they generate electricity continuously as long as radioactive materials decay. So then, what's the catch? And yeah, there's a big catch. The same thing that gives nuclear batteries their long life also severely limits the amount of power that we can get from them. Ultimately, then, it comes down to power and energy. Energy is how much you have, and power is how quickly you could release it. And for the nuclear battery, power is a major limitation. The worst part is that we can't do much to enhance that. There's also the big elephant in the room, the issue of a radioactive isotope constantly emitting radiation for 12, 50, or 100 years. So let's start by breaking down our new battery, the BV100, that the Chinese company Betavolt announced a few months ago. It's a cutting-edge 3-volt battery that lasts 50 years. Technically, it's a betavoltaic nuclear battery that uses nickel-63 as the radioactive source. The radioactive source is paired with a doped diamond semiconductor developed in-house to convert radiation into electricity. It'll be the first battery of its kind to ever be mass-produced. The BV100 is tiny, measuring 15 by 15 by 5 millimeters, smaller than a coin. It produces 100 microwatts of power at 3 volts. That's almost 1,000 times more than the City Labs nanotritium batteries. Yet, it's only enough for low-power devices like sensors and medical devices. Since the sheet of nickel-63 emits radiation in all directions, it's sandwiched between two semiconductors. The little sandwich is one cell. It's like putting a tiny little sun in between two solar panels. The sun is the light source, and these solar cells turn the light into electricity. Nuclear power is equal parts fascinating and misunderstood. Much like ozone, yes, it forms a layer above us protecting us from UV light, but did you know that it also has a 99.9% sterilization rate? It's why our sponsor eufy generates ozone in the water tank of their S1 Pro mopping robot to disinfect your floors. Did you know that the first robot vacuums came out over 20 years ago? And it was this, the trilobite, and it weighed nearly 5 pounds. By 2010, they started coming with laser navigation, and the first mopping robot was introduced in 2015. But fast forward to today, and eufy brings it all together with the amazing S1 Pro. It looks like the next evolution in robot floor cleaning, bringing together 3D matrix eye camera and AI technology for obstacle avoidance, and an excellent square design that maximizes the mopping brush size to cover more area per charge. And it doesn't just have a mopping pad that it moves around, it has a full roller, making it the world's first and best floor washing robot vacuum. And it even takes care of the most stubborn stains. And when it's all done, it returns to base to recharge to refill on ozonated water, which has a 99.99% sterilization rate, and then get back to work. Whether you've got spilled juice, muddy paws, or the aftermath of a busy family dinner, the S1 Pro can handle it. This is what 3 years of refinement and constant improvement looks like. The cornerstone of great engineering. So spend less time worrying about the floors and more time with the people you love. And see why the eufy S1 Pro won the CES 2023 Innovation Award for yourself. Links in the description. Huge thanks to eufy and you. Now back to the show. Betavolt doesn't disclose many of the technical specs, so I have to do a little bit of digging. I found the current versus voltage graph with the power curve for typical betavoltaics. Based on this graph, the cell should work at between 0.75 and 0.8 volts to get maximum power. So you would have to stack four cells to get a peak 3.2 volts of a nominal 3 volt battery. But here's the thing, 100 microwatts is just a trickle of power. An iPhone in idle mode consumes 1 watt or 1 million microwatts of power. So you'd have to stack 10,000 cells just in idle mode and about 50,000 for heavy use. So 10,000 cells stacked together would be 22 centimeters thick. Doesn't exactly seem like a battery you can carry around in your iPhone, does it? But the iPhone 16 Max could fit 50 cells across, which means that would only have to have a battery thickness of about 4.4 millimeters. And that actually would fit in your iPhone. So the betavoltaic battery does have some promise and it has a lot going for it, especially if we stack them to get more power. The question still remains, is it safe? Okay, so the nickel 63 in the BV100 is a beta emitter. That means that nickel 63 is an unstable atom and it decays or breaks apart. When it does, it releases a beta particle, which is simply an electron, and turns into a stable copper atom. There are other types of decay reactions that release other types of particles. The most dangerous types are alpha, beta, gamma, UV, neutron, and X-ray, because they're all ionizing radiation. Not something you want to have contact with your skin. But here's the thing, radiation damage depends on a lot of factors. How far does radiation penetrate? How much energy do the particles carry? And how fast are you absorbing radiation and for how long? So that means we have to measure radiation, and that's where this comes in. So right now, the Geiger counter is measuring a real-time effective dose rate of 0.12 microsieverts per hour. And after 4.5 hours, the person carrying it has absorbed 0.59 microsieverts of radiation. Is that a lot? Is it a little? Essentially, anything above 50 millisieverts or 50,000 microsieverts is dangerous for us and could be enough to cause cancer. Above 3,000 millisieverts, 50 to 70% chance you'll die within 30 days. So here's what we've been leading up to. If I had a betavolt battery in my iPhone and I absorbed all the radiation coming off of one side of the battery, half the total, comes out to an effective dose around 993 sieverts or 993,000 millisieverts per year. And we'd be pretty dead. But of course, that doesn't really happen. Slow beta particles like the ones coming out of the nickel 63 can't make it through a thin aluminum foil, let alone the battery's steel casing. Even if a tiny bit did make it through, it would be stopped by the phone's plastic casing and the fabric in your clothes and on and on and on. So the actual dose is pretty much zero, as long as the battery remains intact. And since nickel 63's decay product is copper, which isn't radioactive, there's no risk of dangerous contamination from using these batteries. So, no, they're not deadly. In fact, the smoke detector on our ceiling is way more dangerous than a betavoltaic battery will ever be. But is the battery brilliant? Well, not exactly either. By choosing the right radioactive elements, it would be possible for betavolt to solve the puzzle and make a practical battery that could put out between 1 and 10 watts. But even then, you're probably not going to ever have a phone or laptop with it. Why? It's because of the cost. When we interviewed City Labs for our previous video, we didn't really talk much about the battery price, but a single nanotritium battery putting out just a few dozen nanowatts of power has a minimum price tag of $5,250. And tritium is cheap in the grand scheme of things because it's a byproduct in heavy water nuclear fission reactors. But the same can't be said for nickel 63. And that's why the cost of a 3 volt, 60 microwatt nickel 63 battery between $500 and $3 million a pop. Now, I do believe that there will be applications where a perpetual, no need to recharge nuclear battery can work, especially for sensors that we have to put deep in the earth or in oceans or far away places, Mars or the moon, places that we can't just keep going and recharging. This could make sense, especially because those applications have deeper funding and could maybe absorb that price tag. But for consumer electronics, it's probably not going to happen. But what do you think? I guess time will tell, but I'd love to know. Sound off in the comments below. All right, that is a quick look at the nuclear battery. Now, don't forget to subscribe, join us, check out our website for the full write-up, all the numbers, all the math, and you can join us as a member to support us and keep us independent. And until next week, I'm Ricky Da Vinci. Thank you so much for watching.